we have seen what are functional dependencies or what are the different operations we can perform on functional dependencies. Now we have to start the next topic here, that is called as a decomposition. Decomposition means if you have a given relation, then you want to break this relation into one or more, two or more than two different relations. For example, if you have a relation ABC, now you want to break this relation into separate parts. Like we can create a relation R1 which is having AB as attribute, and we can have a relation R2 which is having BC as attribute. So decomposition means decomposing a single relation into two or more different relations in such a way that if you combine these two relations again, then the decomposition should be lossless. Lossless means you should not get any extra attribute as well as you should not get any less values as compared to the previous case. Okay, so let us see what is decomposition. I'll come to the lossless decomposition point later on. Right now, first of all, we'll start with what are joins, right? And here we are going to discuss about what is a natural join and if what happens if you do a natural join versus what happen if you do a cross product of two tables. We'll start with what is the natural join and what is the cross product of these two tables, and after understanding the natural join and cross product of two tables, then we'll see what is a decomposition and how can you say a decomposition is lossless, or how can you say the decomposition is lossy. Okay, so first of all, let us start with what is the difference between the natural join. And the cross product. Okay. Assuming that we have the relation R, this is the first relation which is having the following attributes, and this I'm going to give you some values. Assume this is the relation R and it is having the attributes A and B, and these are the values of the attributes. It is A1, B1, it is A2, B2, and A3, B3. And assuming that we have a relation S, the second relation which is S, and it is also having the same attributes, that is, or let us assume it is having a different attributes, that is C and D. And the values of these attributes are C1, D1, C2, and D2. Number one, if you are going to do R cross S, that means the cross product of R and S. If you do the cross product of R and S, then you are going to get one more relation, and that relation will be containing the attributes which are A, B, C, and D. A, B, C, D. Right? And it will be containing approximately 6 tuples. Right? Why it is 6 tuples? If the relation R is containing n tuples and the relation S is containing m tuples, then R cross S should contain n cross m tuples. Right? Here you can see there are 3 tuples and here there are only 2 tuples. So 3 into 2 is 6. And what are those values which we are going to get? That is A1, B1, C1, D1, A1, B1, C2, D2, A2, B2, C1, D1, A2, B2, C2, D2, A3, B3, C1, D1, A3, B3, C2, and D2. That means you have to combine every tuple with all of them. That is R cross. Now, if you take R natural join with this, then what are the tuples you can get in this case? Again, see, if this relation is not having any attributes in common, then natural join will act as a cross product. Okay, this is A, B, C, and D. Now you can see if these relations, or you can say the attributes of the relation R, if I say attributes of the relation R intersection attributes attributes of relation S, if the intersection is equal to 5, that means the relation R and S are not having any attribute in common, then the natural join natural join will act as cross product. Okay, for example, here you can see you're again going to get a1 b1 c1 d1 a1 b1 c2 d2 a2 b2 c1 d1 a2 b2 c2 d2 and a3 b3 c1 d1 a3 b3 c2 d2. These are the values you can get in terms of natural join. Okay, now what if they are having some tuples in common? Assuming that this is the relation R. What if they are having some attributes in common? It is containing the attribute A and B, and this is representing the relation S. It is containing the attributes which are B and C. And assuming the values are A1, B1, A2, B2, A3, B3. And here in the case of S, we are having the attributes as B2, C1, B3, C2, B4, C6, and again B3, C3. Assume these are the values which we have. Okay. Now, if I take R cross S in this case, see, this only difference is here they are having no attributes as common, but here in this case, they are having one attribute as common, that is B. Now, if you do a cross product of these relation, then you are going to get four attributes. That is like this. You are going to get A, B, B, C. Oh, the cross product will become very large here. Okay, so because if this is containing a total of M attributes, or you can say N attributes, sorry, this is containing a total of N tuples, and this is containing a total of M tuples, then R cross L and S should get N cross M tuples. Okay, for example, here there are 3 tuples and here there are 4 tuples, so we should get 12 tuples. So this table will be getting 12 tuples, and all the tuples will be like this: a1 b1 b2 c1 a1 b1 b3 c2 a1 b1 b4 c6 a1 b1 b3 c3 and so on. That means every tuple will be combined with the other tuples. Okay, with R crosses. But if you take R natural join with this, here it creates a difference. Here it creates a difference as compared to the previous case. Now, if you take the natural join, now in case of natural join, you can clearly see there's one tuple, one attribute in common. So we will not take this attribute twice. So we are going to get 3 attributes here, that is A, B, and C. Now, we'll combine only those tuples which are having the values of B as common. For example, here you can see B1 is here, but B1 is not in S, so we are not going to take the entire tuple, right? Here you can see B2 is here as well as B2 is here. So B2 is there, therefore these tuples will be combined, so we should get A2, B2 and C1. Okay, next you can see what is the next value which is common here. B3 is here and B3 is here, as well as B3 is here and B3 is here. So we are going to combine these two rows. So we are going to get A3, B3, C2 and A3, B3, C3. That means you are only going to get 3 tuples here. Okay, so when we do a natural join means if R and S are not having any attribute as common, then natural join will act as a cross product. But if R and S is having some attributes as common, that means that intersection of attributes of R with attributes of S, if that intersection is not equal to phi, then we are going to get the attributes which are not common, like A and C are not common, as well as the attributes which are repeating both of them, we'll take them only once, and we'll combine those tuples where the values are matching. Like here B2 and B2 are matching, so we'll combine these tuples. Here B3 and B3 are matching, so we'll combine these tuples. So that is why we are getting 3 tuples here. Okay, so this is the difference between the natural join and cross product. Now, when we are doing decomposition means if there's a relation R, then we can break this relation into multiple relations. Now, after breaking this relation into multiple relations, if we combine these relations, that combination can be using cross product or that combination can be using natural join. If you're going to combine this relation, then you should not miss out any value which is present here, right? For example, if there's a tuple which is present here, that tuple should come here, as well as you should not get any extra values. Like if some values are not existing here, that you should not get those extra values here, then that kind of decomposition is called as lossless. But if you are either you are getting some extra values or you are losing some tuples, which are, that means the tuples which are present here but not here, if you are losing some tuples, then the decomposition is called as lossy decomposition. So our aim is to get lossless decomposition. To get lossless decomposition, let us study in the next video what are the things which we have to do, or how can you break a certain relation so that you can get a lossless decomposition. Okay.